Bad NBA teams can beat the good ones in the regular season, but it's rare that the complete underdogs upset the favorite in a long playoff series. So when David beats the Goliath, and when the low-seeded teams knock out the title frontrunners, it becomes a memorable story in years to come. Here are the 10 biggest upsets in NBA playoff history. 2020, Denver Nuggets defeat the Los Angeles Clippers 4-3. The potential playoff matchup between the Lakers and the Clippers in 2020 became the hottest topic in Hollywood ever since Brad married Angelina. Never before have the Clippers looked so good, and never before they've managed to snatch a marquee free agent from their big brother. Kawhi Leonard famously shunned the Lakers and chose to go back to Cali with his pal Paul George, refusing to link up with LeBron and Anthony Davis. This created a rivalry the whole NBA world was buzzing about all year long, and the two LA teams were destined for a clash in the Western Conference Finals. However, this rivalry never really came to fruition, because one big man from Serbia had something to say about it as well. After the Clippers took a dominant 3-1 lead in the Western semis against Nikola Jokic and the Denver Nuggets, the series shifted. The Clippers had a double-digit lead in each of the final three games of the series, and each time, Jokic and the Nuggets would come back and upset the heavily favored Clippers, who completely fell apart in Game 7. Paul George was trending on Twitter for all the wrong reasons, and Kawhi had to admit that he isn't the new king in town, while the Nuggets went on to face the Lakers and the actual king. 2016, Cleveland Cavaliers defeat the Golden State Warriors 4-3. Golden State Warriors won the NBA title in 2015, disproving Charles Barkley's theory that jump shots are like pretty girls and starting the three-point revolution. In 2016, the Warriors proceeded to punch through the league with their pace and space basketball, winning 73 games in the regular season and breaking the Chicago Bulls' 72-win record from 1996. Their dominance continued during the playoffs, where Golden State came just a win away from raising another Larry O'Brien, leading 3-1 against LeBron James and the Cavaliers. But because Draymond Green behaved like a squirrel, going after as many nuts as possible during the playoffs, he rightfully got suspended for Game 5. Kyrie and LeBron used Green's absence to steal Game 5 on the road with spectacular 41-point performances, and then tied the series at home, forcing a Game 7. In one of the most exciting final sequences ever, LeBron blocked Andre Iguodala, Kyrie made a clutch three over Curry, who was then stopped by Kevin Love at the other end. The block, the shot, and the stop brought the Cavaliers their first NBA championship. LeBron fulfilled his promise, and the Warriors became the first team to lose a 3-1 lead in the finals. 2012, Philadelphia 76ers defeat the Chicago Bulls 4-2. The Chicago Bulls teams from the beginning of the last decade are one of the biggest what-if teams in NBA history. They had the youngest MVP ever in Derrick Rose, a Defensive Player of the Year in Joakim Noah, a Swiss Army Knife do-it-all swingman in Luol Deng, and other complementary pieces that propelled them to the best record in the league for 2 years in a row. As the number one seed, the Bulls played against the gritty but severely under-talented eighth seed in the Philadelphia 76ers. Everything seemed to be going fine for the favorites until the last minute of Game 1. Derrick Rose made an explosive cut towards the basket, like he did a million times before in his career. Only this time, his knee buckled, and that was all she wrote. Without Rose, the Bulls became another number one seed to lose in the first round of the playoffs. And this was the beginning of an end for that iteration of their team. 2011, Dallas Mavericks defeat the Miami Heat 4-2. In retrospect, this wasn't such a big upset when we look at the depth charts of both teams and how they matched up on the floor. The Mavs had an evenly balanced team with shooters, two defensive specialists, and a superstar who played the best basketball of his career. On their way to the finals, the Mavs swept Kobe and the Lakers, who were the defending champs, and they beat the Thunder with KD, Russ, and Harden. On the other hand, the Miami Heat had three superstars, and not much else. Knowing what we know now, this was a pretty even series. But at that moment, before it all started, the Heat were the Goliath and the Mavs were David. Everybody looked at it as three superstars in their prime against a European blondie who can't defend and a 37-year-old Jason Kidd who was 1 foot out of the league. When the Heat took a 2-1 series lead and had a big lead in the fourth, almost nobody could have predicted the final outcome. However, the Mavs came back and won Game 4, and then two subsequent games as well, providing one of the biggest upsets in NBA Finals history. 2011, Memphis Grizzlies defeat the San Antonio Spurs 4-2. Before 2011, Memphis Grizzlies hadn't won a playoff game, while the Spurs were the most boringly successful team in all of basketball. The Grizzlies entered the playoffs as an eighth seed, while the Spurs had the best record in the West. And nobody expected that the historic success trajectory of these franchises would be disrupted in this series. However, the matchup with Memphis didn't suit the Spurs at all. San Antonio was vulnerable to physical teams who didn't play at a fast pace, and that's precisely who the Grizzlies were. Zach Randolph and Mark Gasol were like two linemen who continually bullied their way through every Spurs player, similar to what Tampa Bay's defensive line did to poor Pat Mahomes in the last Super Bowl. Memphis's grit and grind won the series in six games, becoming just the fourth team in history to knock the first seed out of the playoffs. 2007, Golden State Warriors defeat the Dallas Mavericks 4-2. Golden State Warriors were a synonym for losing in the late 90s and early aughts. They came into the 2007 season with 13 straight years without a playoff appearance, an NBA record at the time. However, in 2007, they appointed Don Nelson as the head coach and brought some fresh blood on the court with the signings of Matt Barnes, Steven Jackson, and Al Harrington. Nelson's run-and-gun style yielded instant success, and the Dubs finally made the playoffs as the eighth seed. But even though they managed to squeeze into the postseason, nobody expected them to do anything against the best team in the league and the MVP of the regular season. Mavs won 67 games that season. Dirk joined the super-rare 50-40-90 club, and the whole world expected Dallas to make another deep run after losing the 2006 NBA Finals. But Nelson and his squad had other plans. They believed that they could do the impossible and knock out the favorites, and the whole city got behind the "We Believe" mantra, which became an unofficial nickname for the team. The We Believe Warriors won the series in Game 6 after a spectacular shooting performance by Steven Jackson, who made 7 threes and scored 33 points. By defeating the Mavs, the Warriors became the first 8th seed to upset the first seed in the best-of-7 series. 2004, Detroit Pistons defeat the Los Angeles Lakers 4-1. From the outside, everything looked peachy in La La Land at the beginning of the 2004 NBA season. The Lakers had the most dominant player in the NBA in Shaq, they had Kobe, who was the best one-on-one player in the league, and they added Gary Payton and Karl Malone, who were hungry to win their first NBA titles. However, on the inside, things couldn't be more hectic. Bryant and O'Neal were at the height of their feud, and the team chemistry was probably the worst in the league. But despite all the turmoil, their talent prevailed, and the Lakers made it to another NBA Finals. There, they would play against the Pistons, who were a good team, but who played with zero superstars on the roster. All evidence seemed to point to another Lakers championship. But the Pistons exposed the Lakers with their defense and playing as a team, while the Lakers played as individuals. Shaq was guarded brilliantly by Ben Wallace, while Kobe was forcing things in the selfish desire to win his first Finals MVP trophy and trying to prove that he's the new alpha dog. Bryant shot just 38% for the series and 17% for three, which wasn't nearly good enough for the guy who was taking 23 shots per game. Detroit won the series in 5 games and produced a major upset, which was the final nail in the coffin of the Kobe and Shaq Lakers dynasty. 1999, New York Knicks defeat the Miami Heat 3-2. In 1999, Patrick Ewing was 36, and his All-Star days were in the rearview mirror. Hampered with injuries, Ewing's aging body gave little hope that New York could be relevant in the playoffs. Without their star player for the majority of the lockout-shortened season, the Knicks barely made the postseason as the eighth seed. That meant they would be playing their old nemesis in the first round, the Miami Heat. In the best-of-5 series, the Knicks and the Heat were even after 4 games, and the deciding Game 5 was the closest one in the series. With 4.5 seconds to go, the Knicks were down by 1 when Jeff Van Gundy called a timeout. If they didn't score, their season would be over. The ball got into the hands of Allen Houston, who made a move towards the basket. His floater hit the front rim, but with a very friendly bounce. It found the bottom of the net with 0.8 seconds on the shot clock. It was only the second time in NBA history that the 8th-seeded team defeated the 1st-seed in round 1 of the playoffs. The Knicks would win 2 more series and proceed to the NBA Finals, where they lost to Tim Duncan and the Spurs. 1994, Denver Nuggets defeat the Seattle Supersonics 3-2. The most famous iteration of the Supersonics was with Gary Payton and Sean Kemp, whose teams were a perpetual title contender in the 90s. The Sonics won 63 games during the 1993-94 regular season, the best record in the NBA, and in the first round, they faced the 8th seed Denver Nuggets, who barely made the playoffs. And even though Seattle had 2 All-Stars, Denver had one of the best defenders in NBA history. Dikembe Mutombo suffocated the Sonics' offense, averaging 6.2 blocks per game and scaring everybody even to attempt a shot at the basket. After losing the first 2 games, the resilient Nuggets won 3 in a row to defeat the heavily favored Supersonics, becoming the first ever 8th seed to produce an upset in the first round. 1981, Houston Rockets defeat the Los Angeles Lakers 2-1. In 1980, the LA Lakers won the NBA title, where Kareem Abdul-Jabbar was the regular season MVP and Magic was named the MVP of the finals. In 1981, Kareem was still widely considered as the best player in the NBA. Magic was the league's premier point guard, and everybody expected them to repeat as champions. The Lakers finished with the second-best record in the West, and they were supposed to make easy work of the seventh-seeded Houston Rockets, who accumulated more losses than wins in the regular season. The first round was played in a best-of-three series, and the Lakers were supremely confident in their victory, even after the Rockets stole Game 1. After they evened the series in Houston, the Lakers surprised the world by dropping another game at home, which meant their season was over. Led by a future Hall of Famer Moses Malone, the Rockets would advance all the way to the NBA Finals, where Larry Bird and the Celtics ultimately stopped their improbable run.